Well, I'm from Montreal, but I've been traveling the country coast to coast for the past few months, talking to people with all the Occupy movement and all the people growing the movement to try to support their communities. So I try to support every action as long as we can and make our world a better place.
Yeah, and from your experience in traveling across Canada, what do you find is this is the 100 days of the movement here. What do you find the
The students got to keep doing what they're doing, and everybody's got to support them. It's doing wonders across Canada, by the way. All my sources all across the country right now are looking at us to pump them up and make them, you know, rise up their people too and try to support the same movement. We've got red squares right now. There's things happening in Washington. There's things happening in New York City. There's things happening in Vancouver, in Victoria. Like, people are getting inspired by what we're doing here. So we got to keep doing that as much as possible.
And what have your experiences been like so far today?
It's been a blast. It's been a lot of fun. Everybody's been in a good mood. Great rhythms with the drum section driving, coming down the street with us. It was a really good time. I think we see people of all different ages. And that's a beautiful thing, that not just the students are here, but people from all walks of life.
And finally, if you had one message for Jean Chavez and the minister, what would it be?
That's quite a loaded question. I'd say, you better make room for democracy, because otherwise you're going to be gone real quick. There's a lot of people that don't like Chavez right now because he's not supporting this movement in any way, shape, or form. And just the rumors of the fact that maybe he wanted to call in more military forces on this, that's a scary thought. This is a people's revolution. You know, it's going to fuel the fire all across the country. So keep it up, and in all face of adversity, just hit them hard. Everybody should be out in the street supporting your kids. The one last thing I just want to say is if you slap your kid in the back of the head, you're considered a thug.